What is going on, JW Faction? My name is Josh Winston. So, it's time for me to give my review on last night's NXT TakeOver Toronto. This is a really good show. It had a lot of great matches. Well, there was kind of one flaw in that one night, but I'll get into that later. But let's get on to the first match. The first match starting off was the Street Profits versus Kyle O'Reilly and Bobby Fish for the NXT Tag Team titles. This is a really good match to start out with. And, yeah, I am kind of happy that the Street Profits once again won. I mean, I love the Undisputed Era, but I've seen the tag team titles on them for way too long now, and I just don't think they need them anymore. But yeah, this is a really good match. They both gave really good performances, and yeah, like I said, the Street Profits won. So, alright, that was a good match. Next match, Candice LeRae versus Io Shirai. This match was a lot better than I thought it would be. And I gotta say, I like this new Io Shirai a lot better. I'm not gonna lie, I like this new heel Io Shirai a lot more. Yeah, her theme song does kind of suck, but that's the only flaw I see with her. But yeah, this is a really good match. And Candice LeRae really gave that Never Say Die performance like her husband Johnny Gargano always does. But yeah. At the end of the match, you know, Io Shirai won the match, which I'm perfectly okay with. Yeah, this is a really good match. And I like this new heel Io Shirai. I think it's a lot better than her former character. But yeah, that was a good match. Next match. Triple threat match for the NXT North American Championship. Velveteen Dream versus Pete Dunne versus Roderick Strong. This was a very good match. Very good match. All three of the performers gave a really heartfelt performance in the ring, and like I said, what am I saying? Anyways, Velveteen Dream won the match, which I'm perfectly okay with. I mean, I would have been okay if any of them won the match, honestly. Like, I love Velveteen Dream. I love Roderick Strong too. He's my favorite member of the Undisputed Era. I mean, I do like him better as a singles competitor, but it is what it is. And Pete Dunne, he is one of my absolute favorites in NXT right now. I mean, normally I get pretty tired of most of the wrestlers I see on top. Like, even though Johnny Gargano, he's probably my favorite in NXT right now, even though maybe he's going up to the main roster at some point. I am getting a tad bit tired of him, but Pete Dunne is just one of those wrestlers that I just cannot get enough of. Like, I love him that much. I mean, I love how vicious he is in the ring. But yeah, anyways, Velveteen Dream won that match. He's still the NXT North American champion. Really good match. Now we get on to the only dud of this night. Shayna Baszler versus Mia Yim for the NXT Women's Championship. This match was not so good. Like, I mean, both performers are good in my opinion. I mean, especially Shayna Baszler, but this match was just not much of what I would expect from NXT. Like, I mean, I like Mia Yim, don't get me wrong, but I didn't really see her dethroning Shayna Baszler as the women's champion. I mean, I'm getting really tired of Shayna Baszler as champion, don't get me wrong, as much as I like her, but I think she's been champion way too long now. But see, there's only one flaw I see with Triple H running a company, is that he overpushes some wrestlers, like, for example, Shayna Baszler. Anyway, Shayna Baszler won this match, which I'm okay with. I mean, the match wasn't all that good, but yeah, Shayna Baszler won. I'm okay with it. I like Mia Yim, but there's only one major problem I see with Mia Yim, and that she's kind of slow in the ring. I mean, she does seem like she drags out a little bit in the ring, but she's still good nonetheless. But yeah, that match wasn't all that good, but yeah, let's get on to the main event: Johnny Gargano versus Adam Cole, NXT Championship in a 2 out of 3 falls match. This match was insane. Like this. Screw the 2 out of 3 falls thing. This match should have been called a 3 stages of hell match. Like the first match was in this 2 out of 3 falls match was they got to make their own stipulation, by the way. Adam Cole chose for the first fall to be just a normal wrestling match. He won that fall because Johnny Gargano got himself disqualified in that fall by hitting him with a chair. And then the next fall was a street fight, and Gargano pummeled Adam Cole throughout, and eventually made him submit in the second fall with the Gargano Escape. And the last match was that particular steel cage match where you can't escape because there's barbed wire on top of the cage and there's weapons in it. I've never seen a steel cage like that before, but I really hope we see more of that. I mean, imagine if War Games does that. I mean, War Games is, I think, the next NXT TakeOver, like War Games 3. But anyways, this match was insane. And Adam Cole won the last fall by there was a metallic table on one of the top corners of the steel cage. They were on top of it fighting, and they both fall off through a table. Oh my God. And then Adam Cole kind of quickly gets his arm over Gargano to pin him 1-2-3, and that got him the last fall, and he's still the NXT champion. I mean, I had kind of gotten over the fact that Gargano hasn't had a single successful title defense in NXT. I mean, yeah, that it still does kind of make me mad, but I don't mind Adam Cole winning the match because I really like Adam Cole, and I can see why Triple H wanted to put the NXT title on him. But yeah, he won that match. And I heard that apparently Johnny Gargano is going up to the main roster. All I gotta say is that if Vince McMahon ruins Johnny Gargano on the main roster, then I will make a video of me saying that I am not gonna talk about wrestling on my channel anymore. It won't be part of my channel. I may even cancel my WWE Network subscription because I will then look at NXT as nothing more than a breeding ground for jobbers. But anyways, all that aside, this was overall a really good night. Most of the matches were great. There was one that was not so good. But what do you guys think? Post your comments down below. Let me know your opinions on this. If you like this video, thumb it up. If you hate this video, thumb it down. And be sure to subscribe and become a member of the JW faction on our journey to 10,000 subscribers. See you later.